Hi students, I am Professor Awais Ahmed Husseini, working as Assistant Professor in Mechanical Engineering Department at Sharad Institute of Technology, College of Engineering, Yadrao. In previous video, we discussed about the classification of the fire tube as well as water tube boiler along with their construction and working. In lecture number 4, we will discuss boiler accessories. So let us start with the working of the steam power plant. We know that the most important component in the steam power plant is boiler. The main function of the boiler is to convert that water into steam, and that same steam is utilized in the steam turbine to produce a mechanical energy in terms of the shaft rotation. And that shaft of that turbine is connected to the alternator of the generator in order to produce their electricity. Further, that expanded steam is enters in the condenser. In condenser, the latent heat of condensation takes place, and the cooling water supply the cooling water in the condenser shell, and that steam get converted into water, and the same water is continuously supplied to the boiler. So this is the basic working of the steam power plant. But here you will get idea about the three important components like superheater, economizer and air preheater. They are situated in line and they are placed in between that combustion chamber. You can say it as a boiler furnace and chimney area. So let us start with the discussion of the function, exact function of that each and every accessories. So here you will get the idea about four important accessories of the boiler used in the steam power plant. The first is superheater, second one is economizer, third one is the feed water pump, and third one and most important is that air preheater. So the main function of the boiler is to produce a steam. So if that steam is saturated, and if we need the superheated steam for a particular application like steam engine as well as that steam power plant, then we utilize that saturated steam in superheater, and that superheater convert that saturated steam into heated steam, and we will get the superheated steam, and you can utilize that steam in the variety of the application of the steam engine as well as for that steam power plant. So here the second one is the economizer. The main function of the economizer is to supply the heated water to the boiler, and it can be done with the help of the flue gases. So here the flue gases is continuously pass over the superheater, economizer, air preheater. So keep in mind that there is no any kind of the separate electricity is required for three components like superheater, economizer and air preheater, but we need electricity for the working of the water feed pump. So here the main function of that economizer is to utilize the heat from that flue gases and convert the regular water which is coming from the condenser and make it hot and supply it to the boiler in order to save the fuel. So the next important one is the feed water pump. We need electricity for their working. The main function of that feed water pump is to supply the feed water to boiler from the economizer. And generally we use that centrifugal as well as sometimes we use that reciprocating pumps. So the next important is that air preheater. So air is required for a combustion process, as well as if the fuel like coal is having some kind of the moisture content, we have to remove it first, and it can be done with the help of air preheater. So these are the important boiler accessories. So let us start with first accessories of the boiler, that is feed pump. It is used to deliver water to the boiler. A feed pump may be centrifugal type or may be reciprocating type, but mostly double acting reciprocating pump are used. In case of the centrifugal pump, it is having its own suction pipe. So from that suction pipe, water is enters and it is coming from the eye of impeller through that motor working principle, and finally it strike on the blade, and the blade is having a very good velocity due to that, and the area of the casing is continuously increases in case of that particular volute type casing mostly used in that centrifugal pump. And due to that centrifugal action, the high pressurized water comes out, and it is used in the supply the feed water from the economizer to the boiler. So this is done with the help of centrifugal pump, but in case of the reciprocating pump, there are two types again, the single acting as well as double acting. The positive displacement pump is there, and in case of that double acting pumps, which means that the liquid enter the boiler feed pump on either side of the pump piston. This with when the piston moves up, suction is taken in the area below the piston and the liquid is drawn in. So this is a very basic construction and working of that that centrifugal as well as that reciprocating pump. So the second important accessory of that boiler is superheater. So why we need superheater? It is a very interesting question. In some application like steam power plant, in case of the steam engine, in case of the processing industry, we need heated steam, more heated steam rather than that saturated steam. So here you will get idea about the drums. There are two drums. Lower drum is related with the water drum and top drum is related with the steam drum. So after evaporation process, whatever the steam is generated in this particular process is saturated. So we supply that saturated steam in the superheated coils, and it get heated with the help of flue gases, which is generated at the end of the combustion process. So that the coils get heated through that flue gases, and at the end you will get superheated steam. So the advantages is there is about 15 to 20 of the coal is saved. So fuel consumption is very saved here. So the second is it increases the steam rising capacity of the boiler. The third one is it prevents the formation of the scale in the boiler. Means some moisture is remains in the steam. The superheated steam convert that particular moisture into dry steam. So this superheater is used to convert that saturated steam to heated steam. And keep in mind that the in case of the superheater, we will get temperature max rather than increasing the pressure. So pressure is remains constant in case of the superheater, but the temperature of the steam is increases. So the next important accessories of the boiler is economizer. So in case of the condenser, whatever the water is collected, it enters in the economizer, and economizer is having n number of the coils. You will get idea of the economizer coil. So feed water in from the condenser and warm water out from that particular tubes of the economizer, and at the end it get enters in the boiler water drum. So there is a no any kind of the separate electricity is required for their working. It works with the help of the flue gases, which is generated after combustion process. So it is very easy to grab the working of the economizer. The advantages are steam consumption of the engine is reduced. Second one is losses due to condensation in the cylinder and steam pipes are reduced. And the third one is efficiency of the steam power plant is increases. So the fourth most important accessories in the steam power plant, which is related with the boiler, is air preheater. So there are two functions of that air preheater. One is in case of the combustion chamber, we need air, means we need oxygen for the perfect combustion process. If that air is having some moisture content, then again it will become dangerous as far as that combustion point of view, and overall the efficiency of the plant goes reduces. So the main function of that air preheater, it utilizes the heat from the flue gases and heat the regular air at a high temperature and supply that air in the passage of the combustion chamber for smooth operation of the boiler combustion process. And second important application and the function of the air preheater is generally in case of the large capacity power plant, we use coal as a fuel. Sometimes in case of the sugar factories, we need a bagasse as a, it is a byproduct of the sugar cane. We used as a fuel in the sugar factories as well as in case of the larger capacity power plant. So if some moisture is remains fuel like coal as well as in bagasse. So that particular bagasse as well as that coal is supply in the passage of the in the area of the air preheater region, and the heated air is continuously blowing over their passage in order to remove their moisture content. So definitely it will enhance the combustion effect which is happen in case of the boiler. So there are few important advantages are increased thermal efficiency, short payback period and increased combustion rate. The third one is in the case of the combustion of the pulverized mean the coal used in the steam power plant is available in the powder form. Air can be used for drying the coal as well as for burning the coal efficiently. And the last one is all standard fuels and even lower grade of coal can be burned efficiently with the help of the hot air. So this is the most important function of the air preheater to remove the moisture from the fuel as well as to supply heated air in the passage of the combustion chamber. So thank you students. So hope you understand the basic concepts related with the how that working and of that different accessories is there. So these accessories like air preheater, superheater, economizer, pumps are essential of for each and every steam power plant in order to efficiency of the steam power plant. Students, keep in mind that the regular efficiency of the steam power plant is in between that 30 to 35%. If we utilize that waste heat and you can use the variety of the modification techniques like use of the accessories, that efficiency goes on increases. So the important thing is these accessories are used to improve their efficiency as well as the performance of the steam power plant. Thank you. Our next video will be on different mountings of the boiler.